Thank you. That concludes the debate on cashback for communities. It's now time to move on to the next item for business, which is consideration of business motion 11143 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and moved.
Thank you. I call on Russell Finlay to speak to and move amendment 11143.2 up to 5 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Scottish Government has spent more than £80,000 on papers about breaking up the United Kingdom. They've just wasted more taxpayers' money to publish their latest instalment of propaganda, which they now want to debate in Parliament. Even Humza Yousaf admits these sit on a website and nobody reads them. Policing is one of the many public services for which the Scottish Government has full responsibility. The outlook is dire for our hard-working police officers who protect the public. In recent months, we've heard a series of shocking announcements about Police Scotland. One senior officer described SNP cuts as slash and burn. The Justice Committee has been told that more than 2,000 police officers could be taken off our streets. The police say they will no longer be able to investigate every crime in the northeast of Scotland. The Police Federation put it in the starkest possible terms. People may die. We are seeing a rise in recorded crime, and that is just what is being reported. The former Chief Constable said that policing is not one of the SNP government's priorities. Yet, in the duration of this parliamentary term, the SNP government has not dedicated a single debate solely on Scotland's police force, although we've already had multiple debates endlessly arguing about independence. My business motion amendment proposes ditching the SNP's planned debate on independence and replacing it with a much-needed, long-awaited discussion on the future of Scotland's police. I'm giving SNP members the opportunity to make it clear where their priorities lie. Is it with the police and giving them the resources they need to keep the public safe, or is it with their own political obsession with independence? I know that my party and I will be backing the police, and I urge all members to do the same. I move the business motion.
Let's hear Mr. Finlay.
I move the business motion amendment in my name. Thank you.
Thank you. I now call on Martin Whitfield to speak to and move amendment 11143.1. Up to 5 minutes, please.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer, and for the formalities, I move the motion in my name. The amendment seeks to alternate a debate from one that the Scottish Government wish to have with one that the Scottish people wish to have. In the previous amendment that has been put, which unfortunately, because of preemption, we will be unable to support, shows that across this chamber there are priorities that exist. My amendment would allow the Scottish Government to talk about the homeless crisis that we have here in Scotland, that which is not unique to Scotland, but one in which our constituents suffer differently, be it they live in a city, and we have Edinburgh that is just called a housing crisis, and those that live in the country, and I think in particular of the constituents across the south of Scotland, but also that homeless crisis that applies to our students. I'm more than happy to give way.
Kate Forbes.
As I understand it, the members on both sides are keen to ditch the debate on immigration and the fact that immigration powers should be in the hands of this Parliament. This week alone, we learned that 7,500 children are stuck in the asylum system run by the UK government. Is that not something that we should be debating?
Martin Whitfield. you.
I'm very grateful for that intervention, and it will be interesting.
Members, well, let's hear Mr. Whitfield.
Very grateful, Presiding Officer. And it will be interesting to see how the motion is indeed framed, and if indeed it talks about those individuals that the intervention made mention of, because there is no indication there in the title that's been offered that that's what it's going to talk about. Whereas both in the amendment that's been proposed from the Conservative Party and the amendment that I move, we are speaking specifically about challenges that we face here in Scotland, that our constituents face, and particularly with regard to homelessness. You know, soon after the recent report from the Trussell Trust on a horrendous increase in the number of emergency parcels that have been had to be handed out and provided for, we are living at a time where there are crises in our community. Those crises are many and varied, as we've heard across this chamber. But one in particular, and one I urge consideration for, is in the state of the homelessness, a situation that during COVID we showed that we could deal with. And now we have abandoned those people. And I move the motion in my name, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. And I call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau. Up to 5 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And it's been a while since we've had one of these discussions at decision time, Presiding Officer. As always, I will try and work constructively with other business bureau managers, and I will continue to do so in the future. And Martin Whitfield's amended proposal for discussion is valid and of merit, and we no doubt will discuss this at future bureau meetings. But it is my belief, Presiding Officer, that Scotland's Parliament must discuss Scotland's future. Mr. Whitfield and I may disagree on what that future holds for us, but it is my belief that Scottish independence provides us with the tools necessary to deal with the issues and the challenges like the one Mr. Whitfield wishes to discuss, and that shows the need for the Building a New Scotland series of papers, Presiding Officer. With regards to parliamentary process, there is nothing in the standing orders which prevents us from discussing matters beyond the powers of this Parliament, and it is not unusual for the Scottish Parliament to debate and vote on motions in areas that are reserved so that proposed Building a New Scotland debate is not new or novel in that sense. We've had numerous debates in the Parliament on reserved matters which have allowed the Parliament to take a position or send a message to those responsible for such decisions. In fact, nuclear weapons was the subject of a members' debate just last week, Presiding Officer. On the 4th of October, this Government brought forward a debate on the UK Government's two-child benefit cap. Members of the Scottish Labour Party, the Scottish Conservative Party, took part in that debate without raising any issues with the reserved nature of the topic. And some members of the Labour Party even criticised us for being too narrow when focusing on the debate on the two-child benefit cap, instead of the wider issues with the UK Government's universal credit system. On migration itself, this is an important discussion for us to have in this Parliament. In April this year, the Scottish Government led a debate on the UK Government's proposed illegal migration bill, and the Labour members supporting the Government's motion, albeit with an amendment, and no such opposition to the relevance of that debate as well. And Scotland's population is projected to begin to fall within the next decade, and the opportunity to discuss this role and that migration can play in addressing Scotland's distinct demographic challenges should be welcomed by all elected members. With regards to Mr. Findlay, it was another exciting and riveting presentation from Mr. Findlay, but at the end of the day, as of 30th of September, 2023, there were 379 more police officers than in 2007, with Police Scotland recruiting almost 600 officers this year alone and around 1,480 new recruits since the beginning of 2022. So once again, Presiding Officer, there is a difference between the reality and what Mr. Findlay talks about. Scotland has more police officers per capita than England and Wales, and higher pay ranges for officers.
Let's hear
of
the
all
Minister.
Ranks. And high levels of investment over the last decade, with 30 officers per 10,000 population, compared to 25 in England and Wales. The recently agreed pay deal is for a 12% increase over 2 years for the police workforce, and for police officers remain the best paid in the UK. So we will take no lectures, we will listen to no scenario from the Conservatives that we are not dealing with the police and make sure that Scotland crime is at an all-time low since the 70s. And Mr Findlay might as well sit down because there's no point in boring us anymore. So with that, Presiding Officer, I would like to say that I have made my arguments forward.
Members.
I have put my arguments forward and I believe that Scotland must discuss Scotland's future.
Thank you. Can I remind members that if the amendment in the name of Russell Findlay is agreed to, the amendment in the name of Martin Whitfield will fall. And the first question is that amendment 11143.2 in the name of Russell Findlay, which seeks to amend motion 11143 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to vote and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access digital voting.